Time has come. Give me a pick. Who wins the title?
All right, D, in the words of my buddy Steve Boucher, you cannot stop the tide. You can only save people from the flood. I think Trevor Lawrence's job tonight is to save the Tigers from the flood, but he's a year too soon, a year too early. I'm going with Alabama.
I think I know the answer, but I got to ask one word here, Paul. Who wins it?
Alabama.
And last but not least, minutes ago, prediction. Who wins tomorrow night?
Alabama wins.
Bama, Nick Saban and Alabama
He's playing
win.
To the crowd here.
Clemson has beaten only one ranked team, this national highly ranked team, Notre Dame, all year. Now, Alabama, in case, has beaten Georgia, LSU, Oklahoma. Now, that lack of competition might be Achilles heel for Clemson.
I need one more word from you. Who wins tonight?
I'm going with Alabama.
Team more likely to win in a rout. I don't see a rout happening, but if it happens.
I don't see a rout happening. I'm going to say Alabama in a rout. If they can just get up on their toes and lean into it and go.
I'm sitting in the morning sun. Sitting when the evening comes. Watching the ships roll in. Then I'll watch him roll away again. I'm sitting on the dock of the bay, watching the tide roll away. I'm sitting on the dock of the bay, wasting time.
Left my home in Georgia. I was headed for the Frisco Bay. I had nothing to live for. Looks like nothing's gonna come my way.
Line was very accurate. Being unbelievable until the moment arises. And Kelly Bryant couldn't handle it last year. Deshaun Watson did handle it quite well 2 years ago. I don't think Trevor Lawrence will be able to handle it tonight.
It's a tremendous third down defense. Only a three-man rush. Lawrence slips a shot downfield, and he has T. Higgins. Brought down inside the 20, save the end zone, save the touchdown.
What a perfect pass. He'll hand it off and give it to ETN coming left side. ETN cuts it to the 15, he's at the 10, at the 5, stays on his feet, and up to the end zone, and in. ETN refused to go
Looks
down.
Looks like nothing's ever gonna change.
Tigers make a statement as ETN.
Everything still remains the same.
It's a shovel pass in the middle.
I can't do what people tell me to do.
For a second time.
So I guess that I'll just remain the same.
Justin Ross, off and running.
Shotgun snap, here comes pressure. He's going to go and look long, running cross. Cross makes a one-handed grab, and the Alabama 45 and is knocked out of bounds.
Bring five. Lawrence picks up the press. Deliverance, and it's
so
in the
center. Rest in my bone.
Wow.
And this moment, this won't leave me alone.
And then he gets down right foot down. That's as good of a catch as you're going to see. Starting offense is going to come out, and they will get a curtain call. Trevor Lawrence will have started 11 games this year. In the last 10, Clemson will have won by at least 20 points. That's incredible.
The Tigers reclaim their crown by crushing Alabama.
What happened?
Well, first off, they ran into the best defense in college football.
I was gobsmacked in that stadium last night. I couldn't believe my eyes.
I certainly wasn't expecting that. And by that, I mean Alabama and Nick Saban being thoroughly in every single facet during every point in the game outcoached.
And how did it end? 44-16. So you go on a 30-3 run on Alabama. That, the ability to do that did shock me.
We talked about it, an incredible performance by Clemson, guys. Only three of our experts actually picked the Tigers to beat Bama in that national championship game. So no revisionist history here where you could say, I was one of them. Nah, just three.
Whatever happened to St. Nick? What happened to Tua for Heisman? What happened to that?
He got stanker going on down there.
I could smell it all the way to Los Angeles because it stinks.
You know what, Skip? I started to bring a property. Yeah. I started to bring a box of Tide and just poured in the tray.
There was a lot of talk about best ever all year long. We were never in that conversation. But tonight, there's no doubt,